Ja, vanuit Nantucket ga ik naar San Francisco. Om daar vanuit naar Nevada te gaan. Naar de Gigafactory.
Net geland. En wat zie ik als eerste hier? Ik zie hier een Model X. Hij is groter, hoger. Maar een mooi kleurtje. En wie komen hier ophalen? De jongens van Mr. Green die een Tesla hebben gehuurd. Wauw, wat is die mooi rood. Was het moeilijk om hem te huren?
Nee, we wachten via Turo.
Ja?
Peer-to-peer carsharing.
Morgen ga ik naar de opening van de factory in Nevada. Kijk, headquarters Palo Alto. En natuurlijk gewoon een bekende scherm. En wie staat bovenaan hier in Palo Alto? Amsterdam, de Netherlands. Kijk, zo snel gaat het dus. Gewoon, dus hier zitten gewoon mensen die producten bedenken. De energy en de auto's en de ingenieurs. We gaan zo meteen naar de fabriek om een rondleiding te krijgen. En daar wordt dus alles gebouwd. Maar hier wordt alles bedacht, gecoördineerd. Er werken hier 1400 mensen. Ik geloof van de meer dan 10.000 die er op dit ogenblik zitten. Maar hier is het zenuwhart. Een van de allergrootste automotive toeleveranciers. 161.000 mensen over de hele wereld werken hier. En dit is dus gewoon een Audi. Ze hebben een van deze Audi's hebben ze van San Francisco gereden helemaal naar New York. 6.000 kilometer. En die rijdt dus gewoon 99% volledig autonomous. En die rijdt hier dus gewoon rond. I'm here in Silicon Valley and one of the people who know a lot about lithium air battery is Alex. Alex, you wrote an article about the whole things about lithium air batteries. How far is that from production?
I think it still has quite a ways to go. I think it's a very interesting energy storage concept.
Giants!
Waking up in the deck, overlooking the hills. Unbelievable. Gorgeous. But this is an old music studio. Everywhere are instruments. And you can use them. And this is the studio. Big screens. On our way to Nevada. Let's stop for the supercharger. We need some. And they're so beautiful. White, black. How long do you like your Tesla?
I love it.
It's fantastic. How long do you have it?
3 years. Just over 3 years.
How many miles?
Almost 30,000 miles. It's no major problems at all. I do have to feel it. It's a computer, you know. It's not a car.
Yeah. So how does it feel driving the Tesla or in the Lexus?
Oh, well, this is much smoother and faster. Boy, when I want to get out on the freeway, there's nothing like having the Tesla.
Uh-huh. And how do you like, what do you think of these supercharger moments that you have to have a break there?
Oh, I love it. We get to meet, various people
from Amsterdam.
From Amsterdam, all around the country. It's amazing. Yeah,
and who gets to take the Tesla who gets to take the Tesla the most?
Of course, yeah? it's his baby.
Yeah. Always interesting to know why people drive a Tesla. The car in the back, the minivan, is going to be replaced by a Model X, which we see there. And I'm just asking somebody who's here why. So you're going to replace your minivan with the Model X?
Yes, because I want to only have two cars.
Uh-huh.
And I wanted the electric car.
Why?
Because it's a computer with a car wrapped around it.
Uh-huh.
Okay, that's why I bought it.
And what is then the way it drives, or is it more the technology itself which is interesting?
It's the technology and everything involved with it.
What did you do for business?
I taught computer science.
Uh-huh. Yeah, we're in Silicon Valley. We have a professor.
On our way to Reno, to the factory, we meet a massive, huge supercharger station. Really a lot of places. And you see also the future here, because these cars in the back are waiting until these guys are ready. And that's what will happen if 500,000 cars come? And okay, and Roy just got his Model X. And Roy is an interesting guy. So, beautiful white. Roy, how long do you have your car?
A month.
Okay, and where is it going?
It's in Palo Alto now, but it might be going to Taiwan.
Okay, how many cars do you have?
Ooh. Tesla's. I have three.
Three?
Yeah.
Okay. And where is your, you also have a Roadster, right? Where is it now?
My Roadster is in Taiwan. It's actually the first Tesla in Taiwan.
You will be very popular and people will... But you're going to take this Model X, ship it in a box and take it with you?
Probably, yes. Planning to it.
Why is that? You pendle between two countries and you for your business?
Yes, and I love Teslas. Well, I love cars, anyways.
Okay, how is the experience with 1 month of Tesla, the Model X?
I love it. It's like driving the future.
Yeah. But what's the So, we have people waiting here for the supercharger. Have you done that before?
Nope, never had to wait before.
Yeah. How does it feel to wait your turn until they're all done?
The turn is happened. Looks like I'm up. We need to go now.
Oh. Well, the waiting time is not that hard.
I don't like it. I love it. I don't like it. I love it.
Oh, you love it? And what's so much fun about it?
Everything. We love it.
Why are you so into electric? Is it because of the environment or because of oil or?
Yes, because of the environment. I'm not because of oil, but environment. I'm very environmental conscious, you know. I watch one.
Ik rij hier op electric drive in Nevada. Ongelooflijk veel space. En daar zie je in de verte de Tesla factory. Nu 14% klaar. 3 van de 13 gedeeltes die gemaakt moeten worden zijn nu klaar. En we gaan eens even zien of we daar een indruk van kunnen geven. How big is this?
So we are here at the party to open the Giga Factory. And everybody you meet here is special because they're not here somewhere. But this is my favorite guy, which I watch all his movies from Norway, Björn. So you now have your Model X for how long? A month?
Yeah, no, not even a month, like 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Yes. So. What do you think of the Model X compared to the Model S?
Model X is like a better car, all over the better car. They have made many improvements over the S. And unfortunately, the facelift Model S doesn't have these improvements yet. For instance, better wipers, adjustable seat belts, perforated seats with ventilation, you know, stuff like that. Yeah. Model S doesn't get it yet. So for now, Model X is still the top spec, like the top car.
But what do you do in normal life?
Well, I work full-time at Statistics Norway as a programmer. Yeah. Statistics Norway is the government. They do statistics and, surveys and stuff. Well, you know, it's always been my passion to make movies. And, you know, now I can also make some money from it, get some nice prizes. I was lucky, but I just, you know, I can make something that everyone get to see, everyone can enjoy my movies.
That's right. Yes. And what do you have now?
I now have the Model X.
The Model X. The signature version.
Yes.
And why did you take the Model X?
Because he sold my Subaru, so I drive a Model X now.
That's only fair, a Subaru for a Model X. What feature do you like the most about the Model X?
The biohazard button.
The biohazard button. Now, I don't have the Model X yet, but why is that so nice?
Because I have very bad allergies, so hay fever, dust, pretty much everything. I always have to drive with the windows up. But in this car, when the allergy season is bad, I push the biohazard button and I can breathe better than any other place. I take longer drive just because I can breathe better, yeah.
So you talk about lithium.
What do you present? What do you present part two?
Yeah, I'm from Norway.
What about the marine sector? Raw materials from mine or from here? Inside this enclosure, we have the anode and the cathode electrodes, which are very thin foils coated in an active material.
We do that and pump it all the way down to the other end of this room, where it enters this massive oven. So we bring in rolls of aluminum foil, unroll them at the far end, and then also at the far end is a coating.
So they're done, they come down here, basically come in one of these trays, and then these racks are basically full of a bunch of these trays with a bunch of these cells. Ultimately, these cells are basically a finished product. Once they're ready to go for Tesla, it's really easy. They just go 10 feet down that way. And that's one of the ways that we're really kind of vertically integrating the factory.
So that's an AGV, it's an automated guided robot. You're probably familiar with us using robots in our manufacturing processes, which you're about to go see on the other side of the wall. It's super cool. Using robots to move materials around in a factory this big starts to make a huge amount of sense. Right, we're moving a lot of stuff really long distances over and over and over and over and over, and that gets really, really expensive. So we can leverage stuff like this, which we call our robot colleagues, right? To help us move material throughout the facility in a really efficient, really effective way. You heard about, you heard Elon talk about the machine that builds the machine. That's the machine that builds the machine. That's one of the machines.
It's up with the bottom cover and we screw it together. It's pretty cool to see where the robots are moving. Modules inside the pod. Inside the module, some of these cells are arranged in parallel and others in series to get the right voltage we need for the drivetrain. The PCB that you're seeing here is part of the BMS.
So, creation of the power wall. And people have to eat. And floor space, office space.
Here is our power wall, which you see to your right. Power wall has about 6.6 kilowatt hours of energy storage and is used for home use. We also take those pods and put them in a power pack. A power pack has 16 pods in it. It has 100 kilowatt hours of energy storage and is used for by our industrial customers.
Okay, that was the end of the tour. Well, we saw how the cells were being created. That was really interesting. And then secondly, how the cells were being used into stationary energy boxes, and later they're going to be used in the Model 3, which is not happening at this moment today. They only built 3 sections. There's 9 more to come, you know, so it's going to be 7 times more building space. And that building, we also only saw 1 floor because this thing has 3 or 4 floors.
Nou, we hebben gekeken hier naar de Gigafactory. Waarom? Omdat hier 1,5 miljoen batterijpakketten per jaar gemaakt kunnen worden. Waarschijnlijk is de helft voor passieve energie storage, maar de andere helft is definitely voor cars. Tesla heet geen Tesla Motors meer, maar die heet nu Tesla. En de reden waarom ze dus die gigantische aantallen nodig hebben is niet vanwege die 100.000 Model X en Model S's die ze maken, maar vanwege de 500.000 tot 1 miljoen Model 3's die ze eigenlijk willen maken. En hierachter zien we dus de Model 3. Een 35.000 euro auto. We gaan even kijken hoe die eruit ziet. Is dat nou echt gewoon een gewone 35.000 auto of ziet die er ook uit op zijn Tesla's? Nou, de Model 3. We zien hem hier. De achterkant ziet er echt uit als een gewone Tesla. Alleen, hij breekt hier af. Dus hij gaat niet zo mooi open. Waarom? Omdat hier een waanzinnig scherm op zit wat helemaal loopt van het begin naar het einde. En als je hier een beetje aan de zijkant naar kijkt, is dat toch wel erg mooi. Hij ziet er echt gewoon de klasse van een Tesla Model S. Elegant, mooi. Maar gewoon een stuk kleiner. En als we kijken hier naar de voorkant, die ziet er eigenlijk meer uit als een soort Porsche. Heel leuk. Daar zit de wereld wel op te wachten. Vandaag geen kans dat ik hem kan rijden, want er zijn veel te veel mensen en er zijn geen Tesla's. Maar Robin, jij hebt erin gereden. Hoe rijdt hij?
Hij rijdt fantastisch. Ja, nog beter dan de Model S.
Beter dan de Model S? Hoe kan dat nou?
Omdat hij compacter en lichter is, maar wel dezelfde power aan boord heeft. Dus het is echt een waanzinnige auto.
Zo, hier sta ik dan in Nevada, midden in de woestijn. En ik sta hier naast, dit is die Gigafactory. Nou, kijk eens even hoe giga die is. Hij gaat maar door. Het is gigantisch. Maar wat eigenlijk vooral interessant is, is dat er nu 3 segmenten van de 20 die er gemaakt gaan worden pas klaar zijn. 14% is op dit ogenblik pas klaar. Waarom ben ik nou godsnaam hier in Nevada? Waarom ben ik hier nou in godsnaam gekomen naar een fabriek die zeg maar 7, die 14% klaar is? Omdat, dat is eigenlijk een beetje een rare vraag. Waarom zijn al deze mensen hier achter mij in een tent, waarvan ik denk dat er zeker 1500 tot 2000 mensen zijn, uit alle kanten van de wereld zijn hier gekomen. Iedereen heeft wel een Tesla, maar de ene heeft 50 mensen aangebracht en de andere 30. En de ene heeft weer een Model X gekocht. Allemaal mensen die hebben allemaal iets hier met Tesla. En die zijn hier allemaal naar die fabriek gekomen omdat ze toch denken dat het een beetje, dat dit toch heel bijzonder is, dat dit historisch is. Dat hier gewoon iets gedaan wordt, en dat zei Elon Musk vandaag er ook. Hij zei van ja, we moeten iets doen wat de naald gewoon een eindje verder brengt. En daar hebben we schaal voor nodig en we hebben prijs voor nodig. Nou, en dat gaan ze dus met deze fabriek zeker doen. De schaal is dik in orde.
Marktaandeel. Gigant.
Nou, dit was voorlopig even mijn indrukken uit Nevada. In de woestijn, in the middle of nowhere. Met heel veel ruimte. Deze fabriek gaat nog 7 keer groter worden. Met een enorme laag batterij, een enorme laag solarcellen eroverheen. Het is hier hartstikke interessant en het is leuk om hier te zijn.